So my name is Vivian Knight. I studied at Aston University and I have a degree in computer science. My current role is I work for Grayce as a technical analyst on their Tech Plus program, and I'm on the software development work stream. I felt that the graduate scheme is a very sort of supportive scheme in which, you know, they don't expect a lot of previous work experience and whatnot. They understand that you're fresh out of university, you have, you know, potentially maybe the technical knowledge, however, you know, the professional skills may be lacking, so they support you through that. Specifically Grayce's program, there's a lot of learning and development alongside, and that really appealed to me because I realized that not knowing specifically what I wanted to do with my computer science degree, okay, I'm gonna try this job, but also, you know, learn other programming languages in the background alongside, and also learn new soft skills in the process, like learn how to work in a team, learn how to really, you know, be a good communicator and things like that. So the Tech Plus program is basically teaching you how to be a technical analyst, a consultant, and you can decide which stream works specifically for you, if you're interested in information security or if it's software development. They provide you continuous learning and development throughout, so they will give you a budget so you can tailor your own program to yourself. So say for me, for example, with a computer science background, I'm quite familiar with a lot of programming languages already, but I thought, okay, I'm unfamiliar with C++. So they gave me the grounds to learn that without any money coming out of my own pocket, you know, fully funded by Grayce. So that was really, really good, and it helps, you know, build my career prospects going on to the future. And then as a result, they'll then put you into a working environment, a professional environment with their client who then uses you as a consultant, like a contractor. So for me, I will log on to my client computer, I will write a list of things that I need to do for the day, we have a morning meeting, a team meeting for the mainframe side, and so we'll discuss incidents that may have come up overnight because I work for a bank. There may be things that have gone wrong with the overnight batch transactions, and so if there's any high severity incidences, that takes the priority, and we break up the workflow and also the work responsibility divided by the team. If there's several low severity incidents, we'll then, you know, take them on a availability basis, you know, who's less busy and whatnot. No day is the same because you never know what might go wrong in a bank. So I'm currently on a rotational program within the mainframe team, so although it will still be a mainframe role, I'll move on from production support to potentially a more development role or a batch testing role. I haven't moved yet, but I feel like it's developed and where I've become a very trusted member of my team. You know, people are relying on me on higher severity incidents, you know, which is quite confidential and quite, like, you know, high risk, but they're trusting me with responsibility and I'm feeling proud of myself for it. My career ambitions, I definitely want to work my way up into becoming, you know, in a senior leadership position in tech. You know, I want to be able to still harness my technical abilities, still be able to, you know, put some impact and input into a product like code and all that. But I want to be able to manage a team, mentor more junior, you know, technical analysts or software developers or anything, and, you know, just kind of help bridge that gap of females in senior leadership positions in tech. A good piece of advice I would say is just keep learning, right? Like, there's no harm in, you know, yes, okay, you might be the master in a particular coding language or a particular skill, but, you know, the more you have under your belt, the more valuable you become. And that applies to both hard skills, technical skills, and soft skills. You know, you could be the best programmer ever, but you might not know how to talk to people. And so just continuously challenging yourself, pushing yourself out of your comfort zone and learning more. More advice I would say is definitely, you know, network, like amongst your team. You never know the kind of connections you might build. You know, you might find yourself becoming, you know, really close to someone in a higher senior leadership position, or, you know, someone in another company that you're contracted potentially with when you move clients, and definitely go outside of, you know, going to different conferences and workshops and things like that. Really engage with outside opportunities there are in, you know, becoming the best possible analyst. You know, get involved with non-profit organizations. You know, there is, for example, Digital Her for women in tech. There is Code Nation. So there's plenty you can do.